Now we'll discuss complements of a set. Okay. So what is complement of set? Usually complement of a set will be denoted with A dash or A complement. Okay. So the complement of a set is nothing but you should not consider whatever elements present in that set. Okay. So other than that elements, whatever the elements you have in the, universal set, all the elements other than the elements in A, whatever elements we have in the universal set, that is the result of complement of a set. Okay. So in a complement of set, if S be the universal set, A is subset of S, then complement of A is set of all the elements of S, which are not the elements of A. So you should not consider the elements of A. So other than the elements of A, whatever elements you have in the universal set, that will be the complement of that set. Okay. So here you see here. So if you see this Venn diagram, A is subset of universal set. Here we use U or S to represent universal set. Okay. So the other than this elements, so this shaded part, which is in yellow color, is the A complement. Okay. So from this, you see this Venn diagram. Now, what is A union A complement? What is A union A complement? Will give you what is that universal set. So, because we are taking elements of A and elements of A complement. A complement means other elements other than A. Okay. So, what is A union A complement is equal to what? It is equal to U. That is universal set. And for example, A intersection B complement. Okay. So, where B is what? Disjoint set. Okay. If B is disjoint set, then A complement is, or A intersection B complement will be equal to 5. That is the set and its complement. Here B dash is nothing but is equal to A dash only. The set and its complement are disjoint sets. Okay. So B dash is nothing but A dash. Okay. A intersection A dash will be equal to 5 because the set and its complements are disjoint set. And similarly, this is de Morgan's law. This anyway we'll be discussing once again. Okay, what is de Morgan's law? Says that the complement of union of two sets will be equal to intersection of the complement of individual set. That is, A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Okay. So de Morgan's law should be verified with Venn diagram only. We will be using Venn diagram to verify the de Morgan's law. Similarly, A intersection B complement. A intersection B complement will be equal to what? The complement of intersection of two sets will be equal to union of complement of individual set. That is A complement union B complement. Okay, these two will be getting from de Morgan's law rule. And what is law of complementation? That is A complement of complement is equal to A only. A complement of complement is equal to A only. That is the law of complementation. Then what is that null set? Null set does not have any element, yes or no? So what is complement of null set is equal to U? That is universal set. Similarly, it is reversed also. Complement of universal set will be equal to null set. Okay. Complement of null set will be equal to universal set, and complement of universal set will be equal to null set. Okay, these are the laws of complement of sets. Okay, any doubts here? Is it clear?
No,
okay. So next we'll see this example. Okay. So here S is given as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, where A is given as 1, 3, 7. Okay, find A complement. What is A complement? Can you tell me now? Other than this elements, whichever elements are present in S. So remove 1, 3, 7. So remove 1, 3, 7. So what are the elements we have? 2, 4, 5, 6. 2, 4, 5, 6 are the elements which are not present in A. So A complement will have 2, 4, 5, 6. Is it clear? Any doubts here? Okay. And see this Venn diagram. So A union B, you know what is A union B? Is this, yes or no? Now we are taking complement of that. If you take complement of that, so other than this elements in the union, whatever elements you have in universal set, okay? So we will be taking this outer portion. You should not consider A union B. Okay, we'll be taking this outer portion. That will be A union B complement. Okay. And what is A intersection B? Intersection B will give you common elements, you know, between A and B, which are common here. This part, the white part is common. Okay. Now you are taking complement. So you, other than this white part, other than this white part, whatever elements you have in universal set, all elements will come under A intersection B complement. Any doubts here, students? Now you see here, we have A, B. Okay. Now we are finding B complement. So what is B complement? You should not consider the elements of B. You should consider all other elements in universal set. Okay. So we don't consider the elements of B. We'll consider all elements here. Okay. And similarly, what is A minus B complement? What is A minus B? A minus B is nothing but we will be having the elements of A which are not present in B. Okay. So we should not consider the common elements between A and B. So this portion, that is why you will not get this complete circle. We'll be getting only the elements of A which are not common to B. Okay. Now what is the complement? Other than this, whatever portion you have, that is blue. Here the portion, the elements in this blue shade, all the elements will come under A minus B complement. Is it clear? Any doubts here? Okay. Then we'll discuss what is algebraic law of sets. Okay. So since all subsets of universal set form algebraic system, okay, so for which a number of theorems are stated. Okay, so you take subset of systems, subset of universal set, all this forms a algebraic system. Okay, so for which we have number of theorems are stated. So in this three, we have most important theorems. That theorems we are going to discuss here. So the first theorem is commutative law. Okay, what is commutative law? A intersection B will be equal to B intersection B. And A union B will be equal to B union A. First one is A union B is equal to B union A. The second one is A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. Okay. So this is the commutative law. Then we have the associative law. The second law is associative law. That is A union B union C will be equal to A union B union C. And A intersection B intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C. Okay. These laws we will be verifying by using Venn diagrams. Okay. We have to use Venn diagrams to verify these laws. Okay. Then we have this. You know that A union A. A union A will be equal to A only. A intersection A is equal to A only. Then we have distributive law. Distributive law is given as A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. Okay. And similarly, A union A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C. Okay. So, these are the algebraic set of theorems, means a set of theorems we use for algebraic systems. Okay. So all these theorems we have to verify by using Venn diagrams. And next we have De Morgan's law. Just now we have discussed, no, in the complement we have discussed about De Morgan's law. Here we are again going to discuss. That is, the complement of union of two sets is equal to intersection of their complements. And complement of intersection of two sets is equal to union of their complement. So these are called De Morgan's law. See here, these two, the last two are the De Morgan's law. A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. These are the De Morgan's law. Okay. So For if you take any two sets, for two sets we have one two more laws. That is, it is given as A minus B union C is equal to A minus B intersection A minus C. A minus B intersection C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. Okay, so these two are the demarcants law. A minus B complement, A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Okay, these two are the demarcants law. These are the two other more laws. Okay. And other laws of algebra of sets is given like this. Okay, for any two finite sets A and B, A minus B is given as A intersection B complement. Okay, B minus A is given as B intersection A complement, and A minus B is equal to A. Okay, when A minus B is equal to A, when A and B are disjoint. If A and B are disjoint, means what? A intersection B is equal to 5. Then the A intersection, if A and B are disjoint, then A intersection B will be equal to 5. So that A minus B is equal to A. And A minus B union B is equal to A union B. Okay. A minus B union B minus A is equal to A union B minus A intersection B. And similarly, A minus B intersection B is equal to 5. All this should be verified with Venn diagram only. Okay. And Venn diagrams we have already discussed, no? Venn diagrams is nothing but pictorial representation of sets represented by a closed figures are called set of diagrams or Venn diagrams. Venn diagrams are used to illustrate various operations like union, intersection, and difference. Okay. So it is a pictorial representation of sets, and we are representing the sets by using closed figures. Okay, that is nothing but Venn diagram. Okay, so this anyway we have discussed already. And this also we have discussed already. Okay, intersection, how do we represent union, how do we represent the difference. The difference will be represented like this. The difference will be having only the elements of A. It does not have the elements common to B also. Okay. It does not have the elements common to B. It will be having only the elements of A, which is not common to B. And B minus A also we have discussed. B minus A is nothing but it will be having the elements of B, which are not common to B. Okay. And complement just now we have discussed. And it does not contain the elements of A. Other than elements of A, whatever elements you have in the universal set, all that elements you will get under the complement of A. And A union B. If A is a proper set of B, in that case, A union B is equal to B only. If A union B, if A and B are given like this, it will have both the elements of A and B. Okay. So elements of A, elements of B, and the elements common to both A and B also. And if A and B are disjoint set, it will be having the elements of A and elements of B. Okay, so this we have already discussed. And this also we have discussed, A union B complement. So it will have the elements which are not present in A union B, which are not present in A union B. A intersection B complement will have the, other than this common element, common part, whatever elements you have, all the elements is included in A intersection B complement. And B complement is, it does not contain B elements. All other elements it will contain. And A minus B complement means what? It is nothing but the whichever elements present in A, which is not common to B. Okay. Other than that, all other elements will present in A minus B complement. Okay. So, before that, we'll discuss one example. So, see this example. So, all of you should solve this example. So, So take this example, all of you. State every possible subset of letters K, B, C, D. Okay? State every possible subset of letters A, B, C, D. So anybody tell me how many subsets are possible here?
16, ma'am.
Very good. Now you please tell me, just write in your paper, okay? Or how do you do it? Okay, you just type in chat box. Let me see. Type in chat box the 16 subsets. Hello, students. Are you typing? Hello, students, are you typing or not? Okay. So, De Morgan's law we have discussed, no? Any doubts in De Morgan's law? All of you are clear with De Morgan's law? Okay. Take this problem. See this problem. S is given as the integers 1 to 12. S is given as the integers 1 to 12, where A is equal to 1, 3, 5, 12. Hello, students. Are you there online? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So S is equal to 1 to 12, A is given as 1, 3, 5, 12, and the B is given as 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and C is given as 1, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Then what is A union B? A union B will be having all elements of A and all elements of B. And it should not, it should have only distinct elements. It should not repeat. Okay. So here anyway, A and B, A and B are disjoint sets anyway, so it A union B will contain all elements of A and all elements of B. And you see this A intersection B, what is A intersection B? Will be equal to null set, because it does not have any common element. And similarly, you see A union C, A union C will be, see here 1, 3 is repeated, so 1, 3 will be appeared only once. Because when you are writing set, you should write only distinct elements. You should not write repeated elements. So it is 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12. Okay. And what is A intersection C? Whichever elements are common here. What are the elements common here? 1, 3. The elements 1, 3 are common, so you will be getting 1, 3 here. Similarly, B union C. B and E and C will be writing all elements of B and C. If the elements are repeated, you should not write it once again. Okay. Only once we have to represent the elements in the set. And A inter B intersection C is whichever elements are common. In this case, whichever elements are common? 6, 7, 8. The elements 6, 7, 8 are common here. Okay. And similarly, what is A complement? So, other than A, whichever elements are present. So one is present in A, so you should not write other elements. 2, 4, okay, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. So those are the elements for A complement. What is B complement? B complement here, B we have 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No? Other than this, whatever elements you have in S, other than B elements, whatever elements we have in S, that is nothing but B complement. So what is B complement here is 1, 3, 4, 5, 12. Okay. And similarly, C complement. We are writing C complement. So other than this elements of C, whichever elements present in S are the C complement. Okay. So like that, we will be writing the complement. Okay. And see this example, one more example. What is De Morgan's law? Okay. So if you take this example, A is given as, it has elements from 2 to 16, whereas B is having the elements from 5 to 22. So what way of representation of this set? We have discussed now two methods to represent the set. First method is what? There are two ways to represent the set, Mama. What is the first method of representing the set?
Tabular.
Yes, tabular. Second one is?
Rule based.
Yes. The second method is rule based. Okay. So first method is regular column method and second one is rule based method. Okay. See this example here. So here A is given as A value is between. This is rule-based method of representation.
Your voice is not clear.
Now? So if the meeting is ending, you know, you please join with the same meeting ID number. Okay? Okay. So it is that... This method of representation is rule based. Here capital A is used to represent the set. Okay. Set and the small a is to represent the elements of the set. Okay. The values are 2 to 16. Whereas B values are from 5 to 22. B values are from 5 to 22. And S values. What is S? S is nothing but universal set. It will be having all the values. So 2 to 24. It is having the values from 2 to 24. Okay. Now C is defined like this. C is given as A intersection B. What is A intersection B? So since A is from 2 to 16, whereas B is from 5 to 22, whereas C will be, which is the common range? 5 to 16. C range is 5 to 16. Okay. Then what is C complement? C complement is nothing but A intersection B complement. Okay. So C complement is equal to A intersection B complement. So it is equal to, what is A intersection B complement? See here. It is 5 to 16. No? Before 5, what are the elements you have in S? It is from 2 to, it is from 2 to, 2 to 5. Okay, then 16 is covered here after 16. 16 less than, C less than or equal to 22. That is nothing but C complement. Okay, now what is De Morgan's theorem says? De Morgan's theorem says that A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now find out what is A complement. No? What is A range from 2 to 16? No? So A complement is what? A complement is, since S is also from 2 to 24, so it is from A complement is, I'll write A complement here. A complement is, it is 16 to 24. It is 16 to 24. Yes or no? That is A complement. Okay. Now what is B complement? B complement here it is 5 to 22, no? So before 5, what are the elements you have? 2 to 5, okay. Then 22, till 22 it is covered. After 22, to 24. Okay, so that is your B complement. Now what is union of these two? The union of these